James Marsh this morning from Andromeda Metals. James, good to see you. Good morning.
Good morning to you, Andrew.
A fair bit to catch up on. James, look, firstly, a couple of serious updates this week in terms of offtake, one for China, one for Japan. Tell us a bit more about them.
Yeah, so this is a very important step forward for us because these are full binding long form offtakes. So no ordinary offtakes. These are take or pay deals, which means they are absolutely crucial for the next stage of the project and also for our funding, which we're now our debt funding, which we're now looking for. So this is a very important stage, one in Japan with a multi-generational producer of porcelain tableware and another one in China with a major player in this industry. So that's great. And I'm heading back again to China next week to do some more deals, hopefully.
And how is your new chief executive, Bob? How's he settling in?
Yes, Bob's done what, just over 1 month now with the company in the MD role, and he's got vast experience in industrial minerals, so he's been a great asset to the company. He's really helping us to drive the company forward to the next stage into production operations, and he is in fact presenting today in Sydney to investors and shareholders, and doing the same in Melbourne next week. And we actually released his presentation this morning on the ASX, so I would urge any of you who want to learn about what he's going to be saying, and there's some very interesting stuff there. He's going to be talking about new developments, new applications, and new opportunities for us.
Well, what are some of these new opportunities, James?
So at the moment, we've been doing a piece of benchmarking, international benchmarking work in tiles, and these are no ordinary tiles. This is real architectural, large format tiles, 3 by 2 meters, and these things are very high quality, very expensive. They've got digital printing, which means they need very high quality materials. Spain is the global capital of technology for this. So we're doing a benchmarking work, piece of work in Spain. And we found that we have a truly world-class product for that application. And we are now moving that forward with some potential customers in that part of the world, because there's a big gap now in the market. Obviously, with Ukraine out of the picture, unfortunately for them, it's not just around Asia. The Europeans are now looking for material just like ours.
And as far as the Great White project itself, how are developments, how are the financing discussions?
Yep. So at the moment, as I said, we are positioning ourselves as far as the mine goes to address some mega trends at the moment around the world. And this includes urbanization, technology, and decarbonization. Three very important subjects. Now we have a product that to address all three of those. So that's we're in an excellent position. So we're now development-wise, we're looking at how we balance the mine to market versus a market to mine approach from what we have, this world-class asset that we need to make the most value of, so value and use of that we can. So we're working very hard towards that. And on that basis, have just opened a data room, a virtual data room. This is what the debt funders are now looking at as of today. This will be opened up to a number of prospective lenders. We're also updating our definitive feasibility study, and that's on the basis of this market to mine to market balance, because we now realize that we have something that is very valuable and highly desirable in a new application area. So that's being done at the moment. Construction on the mine site and for the plant should be starting next month. So that is very close now. On that basis, we're looking at getting the first shipment to our customers by October 2024.
Well, some big milestones ahead for you. James, good to speak. Thanks very much.
Thanks for your time, Andrew.